Hello and welcome to everyone. So today we'll be dealing with a government scheme called Pradhan Mantri Matsya Sampada Yojana, and this scheme has been announced by the Finance Minister Nirmala Sitharaman in the Union Budget 2019-2020. This scheme is in line with the Union Government's objective of doubling the farmers' income by the year 2022-2023. So it is a flagship scheme under the Ministry of Fisheries, Animal Husbandry and Dairy, and this scheme aims to bring out blue revolution through focused as well as sustainable development. So it does not intend to do exploitation, it does not intend to bring out development through exploitation, but it aims to bring out the blue revolution or development of the fisheries sector through focused as well as sustainable development of the fisheries sector. And the estimated investment of this scheme is about 20,050 crore, and this amount is the highest ever that has been received by the fisheries sector. So you should keep in mind what the amount is. It is 20,000 crore, approximately 20,000 crore amount has been kept aside for the implementation of this scheme, and the scheme has to be implemented within a 5-year time span. So this time span is from the financial year 2020-21, that financial year to 24-25. So the time span is about 5 years. And this scheme is part of the Atmanirbhar Bharat package. So this scheme aims to bring self-reliance to the farmers or other stakeholders involved in the fishery sector. And also out of this 20,000 crore amount, about 12,000 crore is proposed for the beneficiary oriented activities, and an amount of about 7,000 crore is kept aside for the infrastructural development. So Pradhan Mantri Matsya Sampada Yojana is an umbrella scheme, and it has two components. So one is a central sector scheme and another one is centrally sponsored scheme. So both the central sector scheme as well as centrally sponsored scheme, they have subdivisions, that is non-beneficiary oriented scheme as well as beneficiary oriented scheme. So in case of central sector scheme, under the non-beneficiary oriented scheme, the central government will provide 100% of the amount to the states. So for the non-beneficiary oriented scheme, under the central sector scheme, the central government will provide about 100%, that is the full investment will be done by the central government itself, and no investment has to be given by the state government. But in case of beneficiary oriented scheme, the center assistance will be about a 40%, and for the scheduled caste, scheduled tribe and women, this investment of the central government will be about 60%. And the other one, in case of centrally sponsored scheme, so what happens here is that the central government will provide a part of the amount, and the rest of the amount should be given by the state government. So in case of a non-beneficiary oriented scheme, here a huge part of it, that is about 90% of the amount, will be provided by the central government itself, because the central government want to help these northeastern state to develop their fisheries sector. So for that, the central government will be giving a 90% of it. And for other states, it is 60-40. The central government will provide 60%. The states will provide 40%. And in case of the union territories, the whole amount will be invested by the central government itself. So under the centrally sponsored scheme, there are other components which includes the enhancement of production and productivity. So just investing the money by the government is not enough. This money should be utilized, that is, this money should be helpful to increase the productivity of the fisheries sector. So this has to be enhanced, this has to be ensured. Then the infrastructure, as well as so as to reduce the post-harvest losses. So such components has to be considered. Then various regulatory framework for the fisheries sector. So all these components comes under the centrally sponsored scheme. So while bringing this scheme out, the central government has certain desirable outcomes in mind. So which includes of to increase the fish production to 22 million metric tons and that too by 2025, and to increase, another one is to increase the gross value added. So what is gross value added? Gross value added is the total value of goods and services of a particular sector. So here it intends to increase the gross value added of the fisheries sector in the overall gross value added of the agricultural sector. So, it intends to increase the value of fisheries sector producers, that is goods and services. Then, it also intends to double the exports. So, to double the exports, what we need is quality products. So, for that, infrastructural development should have to be there. Then, generation of 15 lakh direct employments. We'll come to that. The scheme is linked with other schemes. So, this linking and convergence of schemes will help to increase the employment opportunities of this, and we'll come to that. So, now let's see the various objectives of Pradhan Mantri Matsya Sampada Yojana, which includes of harnessing the potential of the fisheries sector in a sustainable, equitable and inclusive manner. So, it does not include of utilizing the fisheries producers in a exploitative way, but in a very equitable manner, in a very sustainable manner, keeping aside for the future. And it also includes the efficient use of land and other water resources and other resources. Then modernizing the value chain, bringing the scientific and technological advancements, innovation into the fisheries sector, and also to provide various social, economic, physical security to the fishermen as well as the fishing farmers. So, earlier we saw various objectives of the Pradhan Mantri Matsya Sampada Yojana. So, to bring this objectives, these objectives into practical, the Yojana or the scheme has brought out various approaches, and we'll see that. So, first one is catch to customer, that is the post harvest infrastructure management. So, ensuring that the catch, that is the fish, reaches the consumer in the same status, that is in a very fresh manner. So, if the catch has to receive the end consumer in a fresh manner, what does that mean? It has to ensure that, the government has to ensure that there is proper post-harvest infrastructure. So, cold storages, the transportation facilities, all of those has to be in place. So, under as we already saw, the scheme also covers the infrastructure. So, about 7,000 crore is kept aside for the infrastructure. And then ensuring the private sector participation. So, the including of private sector or including private sector participation in the fisheries sector would help to bring innovative ideas into the sector. It will also help to promote the ease of doing business as well as to develop various business models. So, bringing in the or promoting startups, incubators, etc. Will be beneficial to the sector. Another thing is the cluster or area based approach. So, rather than concentrating on the country as a whole or on a particular state, it would be better to concentrate in a cluster or area based manner, so that the government can concentrate on that area to develop their infrastructure, so that the quality of products or producers, fisheries producers from that particular area will be much higher. So, that is very much beneficial than an overall approach. Another approach to amplify the outcome or to increase or widen the possibility or the outcome of the Pradhan Mantri Matsya Sampada Yojana is to link or converge this scheme with the other schemes. So, with the schemes like the Sagarmala project of the Ministry of Shipping, with the PM Kisan Sampada Yojana, and it can be linked with the Maganrega. So, by that, and even the National Rural Livelihood Mission. So, by linking this scheme with the other schemes, we can generate much more employment opportunities. So, the workers of Maganrega, the people who are working under Maganrega or the National Rural Livelihood Mission, these people can get the job opportunities or the employment opportunities under the fisheries sector. So, when the government is investing a huge amount of about 20,000 crore to the fisheries sector, it has to ensure that the scheme is being properly implemented and that the amount is being properly utilized. So, for that case, the institution, it has put in place one institutional mechanism for that, for ensuring the implementation of it, which is called state programming units or the district programming units, and even sub-district programming units are kept in place. So, the government has incorporated various scientific, technological and even innovative ideas into the scheme so as to ensure the effective utilization of land as well as water. So systems like, or several techniques like aquaponics or even the bioflock, the recirculatory aquaculture systems are all being utilized here. Also under this scheme, approaches are being taken to give much more emphasis or to importance to the fishery sector development of Jammu and Kashmir, Ladakh, even the northeastern areas in which the fishery sector is not much developed. So such areas are being given much more emphasis under this scheme. So as we saw, the Pradhan Mantri Matsya Sampada Yojana is a yojana or a scheme which has the objectives of doubling the farmers' income, doubling the exports, and also to increase the quantity as well as the quality of exports that are going from India. So that was about that scheme. So now we'll see another intervention in the field of animal husbandry. It is the eGopala app. So the eGopala app has two functions. One is being an information portal, and another one is being a comprehensive breed improvement marketplace. So in this marketplace, it allows the farmers to buy and sell disease-free germplasms in all forms. So the main aim is to provide quality breeds. So for that, the disease-free germplasms in all forms are made available in this platform. So that kind of a service is available, and also information about the various government schemes, campaigns, treatments, nutrition, all of that is available in this app. So that's for today. Thank you.